everyone. I'm Kelsey Robinson, and I'm an outside hitter for Team USA. I am currently on my 7th professional season here in China, and I am in quarantine right now, waiting to start my next season. As a part of USAVlearn, I thought I would talk about something that has been extremely vital to my success as a player and has allowed me to have a pretty long career. Something that I live by and I play by is just the idea that I want to step on the court and make the people around me better. Now, this sounds super ambiguous, and you're probably thinking, well, duh, we all want to make the people around us better. But especially when we're young, and especially when we're still developing and learning the game, I think a lot of us focus on, you know, how do I get better, or how do I win, or, you know, a lot of the things are very individual, and of course we want the team to succeed, but we also all probably want to get a scholarship or, you know, want to do well and potentially play pro. And those are all super great goals. But I think for me, I wasn't always the most athletic or the most talented. I didn't jump through the roof and I wasn't scoring all the points, but this philosophy has allowed me to have a very long career, and it has made me very valuable to all the pro teams that I've played for and with the national team. And I think when we take the focus off of ourselves as players and we put it onto making the people around us better, we end up elevating our own performance. So you're probably wondering, how do we do this? What are the steps that you take to make the people around you better? Number one, I think an eye contact and a handhold go a long ways. I think making people around you better is all about building that trust and building that foundation in your relationship. And so when somebody is playing next to me, I always make it a point to have good eye contact when I'm telling them feedback or when we're exchanging information about the play. We always make eye contact, and let's say we're going back to serve receive. If instead of just a simple high five, I make sure I hold that person's hand and I look them in the eye, and it just builds that foundation, that trust that they know that I'm here for them the same way they're there for me. And so now we have this good communication, these good seams, and they can't just, if something bad happens or maybe they make a mistake or I make a mistake or a ball lands in between us, they can't just walk away from me and, you know, turn around. Now I'm going to make sure I grab them and make sure we know that we're in it together. Number two, I get to know my teammates. I don't think you can build that trust without putting in the time to get to know your teammates and getting to know, you know, what fires them up, what tears them down. How do we pull the best out of each other? And for example, what Tori Dixon might need is probably different than what Jordan Larson needs. And so putting the time in to get to know your teammates is extremely important. And now that I've put the time in to get to know them, they're probably going to be more receptive to information or feedback that I might have to give them. Number three, letting your teammates know that you're there for them. This might sound super simple, but it goes a long way. For example, let's say we're in a tight moment and it's 22-20 at World Championships and we need to win this match. If I have an opposite next to me and I'm in the back court, I'm going to go up to her and I'm going to say, swing as high and as hard as you can, and I'm going to be right there covering for you. I won't let that ball drop. And now she knows and she has all the confidence in the world that she can just go high and hard and take a rip at it, because that's what we probably need from her instead of a timid, I'm afraid of the block swing. Another example, if I have a setter who, you know, maybe she's having an off game or maybe she's on fire, but things are a little bit inconsistent, it's my job and my responsibility to get my feet to the ball and make sure I can handle an inside set and a long set and something off. And even if she doesn't set me something perfect, I'm going to be able to get my feet there and I'm going to get a great swing. And in return, that's going to build her confidence slowly to get back to the rhythm that she needs to be in. Lastly, if I'm in serve receive and I am in the back court and I have a front row outside, maybe she's struggling at passing right now and she might be in her head, or again, even not, I still do this, even if somebody's having a great match, just saying, hey, if you need to go, go, I will cover you, I will pass this ball, go out and worry about attacking. And that just gives her confidence. And in return, I think she knows that I'm there for her. And now we have this chemistry and this trust. And I think being somebody who's not the, you know, star or most athletic or scoring every single point, I think it goes a long way that people around me can play to their maximum potential because of the small little things that I do that nobody, that's not on a stat sheet, nobody sees it, but it makes you incredibly valuable as a player. And like I said, it has allowed me to have such a long career because I elevate the people around me and I put the pressure off myself and I make it about the people I'm playing with. And in return, it's much more fun to watch everyone succeed and to win as a team. I think this is something we can all do. It's not designated for certain people. Everyone can do this. And especially for people with tryouts or maybe you are still learning the game, I think it just takes all that pressure off of yourself and it makes it way more fun. So I would highly encourage everybody to try this, to think about, you know, how do I make the people around me better? How do I elevate their performance? And I think in return, you're gonna see this go such a long way for your own performance.